Hey everyone, welcome to SideNotes, the note-taking application for Mac OS that allows you to monitor and manage your notes without distracting you. In this video, we're going to run you through some of the key features of the application so that you can use it to its full potential and unlock some productivity that you may never knew you had. So let's kick off by looking at how to start SideNotes, and there are several ways to do this. Once it's installed and you run it for the first time, you should see a bar on the right-hand side of the screen. It's designed to be out of the way and not distract you. If you click on the bar, the SideNotes panel will open. And then to hide it, simply click on the panel once more and it's gone. You can also activate the Notes panel via a keyboard shortcut. If you type Control, Alt, Command and Space, then the panel will appear. And if we open up the preferences for SideNotes, which we can do by pressing Command and Comma, there are some more options at our disposal. I'll run through all of these preferences in detail later. However, it's worth pointing out that if you prefer having the SideNotes panel on the left-hand side of the screen, you can change that here. However, to show or hide the notes, at the bottom half of this preferences window, there are a couple more options available to us. Currently, it's set to use the open bar, but you can change this to a hot side, which is my own personal preference. Let's select that. And I'll just click away to hide the SideNotes panel. And now all I have to do is move my cursor to the far edge of the screen and the panel appears. There we are, a very simple action there. And it doesn't stop there. An update to version 1.1 of the application includes a menu bar icon. So let's select that. And the panel is just open there because I've made the preferences window active. And because the preferences window is part of SideNotes, it's pushed out the panel for us. But now up in the menu bar, there is an icon. I'll just hide the SideNotes panel by clicking on the open bar. And I can show or hide SideNotes by clicking the icon. As well as options for showing the panel, we have some further options here for how the panel can get closed or hidden. We can hide the notes by clicking on the empty space between the apps here. Also, you can select to hide the notes whenever you click outside of the application. And then finally, you can choose to hide the open bar when the mouse is inactive. Let's select that. And the open bar disappears. And when I move the mouse, it's back again. Also on this page, we can select to launch SideNotes on startup. So that covers how to make the panel appear and disappear. Let's run through now how to create notes. So there are different kinds of notes that we can create, and we can organize them in folders as well. Now, when the app's installed, we're provided with a tutorial folder that contains a variety of notes within. So I'll double click on that. It's called Showcase. And we have 9 sample notes in here that showcase some of the different note types and modifications that you can make. Now, by default, new notes are written in Markdown format. So if you use Markdown, that's a huge plus point. And if you're still learning the Markdown syntax, then you can manually make modifications to text via the dropdown here. We can change the colors that are assigned to notes as well by clicking on the cog and selecting a color. And as we scroll down, we can see the different note types available. We have to-do lists, images, also there are hints and tips here relating to the app. And there's an example of a code block note and also a list of shortcuts at the bottom. But let's go back to the top of this list though, and I'm going to create a new note. So I'll click the plus button in the top right hand corner and I'll start typing my note. As I said earlier, you can write in Markdown by default. And if I highlight some text, come down to the text transformation icon, I can select something here if I can't remember the Markdown syntax. There is, of course, a keyboard shortcut for creating new notes. Pressing Control, Option, Command, and N will automatically open a new note. Then enter your text, and there you have your new note. Creating task lists within SideNotes is simple. Let's add a couple of tasks in here. I need to wash my car, and I need to pick up the kids. So if I highlight all of this text, then go down to the text transformation icon, select to do, and we now have check marks that we can check off as and when we complete the task. Next, we can paste notes directly into SideNotes. I've got the Aptorium webpage open here, and I'm going to highlight some text here within Safari. Then once it's highlighted, I press Command C to copy it to the clipboard. And I'm going to go over now to the SideNotes open bar. And if I long press on the plus button, we've got some more options available. And I'll run through all of these later. However, for now, we want notes from pasteboard. And there, the text is copied across. You can also, within preferences, create a shortcut for this action as well. Okay, we've been adding a few notes to our showcase folder, but that's not where I want to keep them long term. I want to have any notes that I create now sent to a different folder, one for testing purposes. So I need to create a new folder, and we could do that by clicking the plus button, as we did earlier, if we like, or alternatively, we can type the keyboard shortcut Control, Option, Command, and N, which is to create a new note. And when we press that in the folder view, it's going to create the note, but we can specify which folder to place it in. So I'll press that, and a folder picker appears. And it knows we want to create a note, and if I click Create Note Now, then it will be created in the Showcase folder. However, if I click the drop down and select New Folder, I've got the word test already typed in. So I'll tap Create Note, and the new note is ready for me to draft, and it's contained within the new folder. We saw earlier that one of the note types that we can have is images. So I'm going to open up Finder, where I've got some image files here. I'll click on one, and we'll drag that across into the new note that I have. And it pastes in there nicely. I can create a new note here as well from an image. It doesn't just have to be appended to an existing note. Let's drag this Rise of Skywalker image across until we see the green plus sign. And I'll release, and there, we've got another new note as well. And you can have multiple images on a note. You're not limited to just one. I'll drag this one across, and it snaps nicely underneath the existing one. Now that we've created a new folder, let's move the stuff that I've created in the Showcase folder across. I'm going to double click on Showcase, and there is an arrow in the footer of the node that is a Move To button. So I'll tap that, then select the folder I'd like to move the note to, in this case, Test, and the note moves. Now onto the other two notes. Click the arrow, select Test, and then repeat that process for a third time. So let's verify now they've moved across. Okay, I'm going to click the back arrow, and our folder list appears, and the item count within them has changed. There were 12 items in the Showcase folder and 2 in the Test. It's now 9 and 5 respectively. So I'll double click on Test, and all of my notes are in there. So organizing notes within SideNotes is a very simple process. Okay, let's finish creating notes directly from the application by looking at lists. Now, SideNotes allows you to create lists on the fly with ease. I'm going to click on plus to create a note, and I'm going to give this note a title. This is going to be a list of apps that are available on the Aptorium website. And I'm going to start typing them out. We have SideNotes, then Workspaces, and I'll just pause the video now while I complete them. Okay, that's all of them listed. I want to give this note a header, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to highlight the title, then go to the text transformation button and select header. Alternatively, I could just type Shift Command H or put a hashtag before the text. That's the power of Markdown. Next, let's highlight all of the apps and go to the text button again. This time I'm going to select list, and they all appear listed in Markdown format. Now I'm going to press Command Z to undo that last lot of formatting. I'm going to go back to the text button, and this time I'm going to select the ordered list option. And this shows all of the apps here in numerical order from 1 to 9. Let's move this one stage further. Let's say we want to buy these apps and mark them off as they're purchased. I'll just press Command Z again to undo. And this time when I click the text button, I'm going to select to do. And now they've all been turned into to-do list items, and I can check them off as I go. Now you may be in another application and wish to send content to SideNotes. If that's the case, you are covered because SideNotes has a share extension. To use it, it does need to be enabled, and there are several ways to do this dependent on where you are in the operating system. So I'm here on the Aptorium website, and I want to make a note of this URL. So I'm going to click on the share button, and SideNotes doesn't appear in the list of default applications here, so I'm going to select more. Then I'm going to check the box to the left of SideNotes, and I'll close this window. Then I need to click on the share button one more time, and there SideNotes is. I'll select it. I'm prompted for a location to place the note. Now I'm happy for this to go into the test folder, although I can select another folder or indeed create a new one. But I'm okay with this. I click Create Note, and the URL is stored in a brand new note. As well as web URLs, we can share images and files from Finder and create notes from them. So I'm going to go down to the dock to open up Finder, and I have the Workspaces icon downloaded to my Downloads folder. I'm going to right click on this and select Share. And then from there, I'll select SideNotes. SideNotes does need permission to be able to access my Downloads folder, so I'm going to say OK to that. And as before, I need to select a location for the file. So I'll stick with the test folder. And there we have our image file. And whilst we're here, it's worth pointing out that these notes aren't just images or just text. You can have a combination of the two. I'm going to close this. And if I wanted to copy some of this text on this web page to SideNotes, then I can do that too. All I need to do is highlight the text, right click, select share. And then if I select SideNotes, I'll have another new note created. The final share type that I'll show you is a document. So I'll open up Finder once more from the dock. And I've got some text documents here. I'm going to right click on one of them, select share, choose SideNotes again, and I'll select the default folder by clicking create note. And we can see on the right hand side here, we have the title of the text document in the lower half of the note, and the contents have been extracted and they are in the main body. Another way of getting stuff into SideNotes is from your iPhone or iPad. Now you need the devices to be on the same Wi-Fi network for this to work. And I've just changed accounts here quickly so that I'm signed in with an account that is also signed in to an iPhone and iPad that I've got here. So to add an item from your mobile device, you need to be in the folder that's going to receive the file and then long press on the plus button. Now in here we have some choices, and because I've got two devices available sitting on the table here, I'm going to hover over import from iPhone or iPad, and we can see both of my devices are there. And you have the same options for both. I can either take a photo, scan a document, or add a sketch. Now I don't need to show you them all, but I would like to show you one. So let's go for add a sketch, and I'll do that on my iPad. So on my iPad screen currently, it's opened up an Apple Note, and I'm just quickly writing out a brief note here. There, that's done. And I'll tap done on the iPad note. And there, within less than a second, that's appeared now as a note within SideNotes. So you can add drawings, you can add manual notes, you can add photos, and scan documents to SideNotes directly from your mobile device. Searching within SideNotes is almost effortless. Click on the magnifying glass to bring up a separate search window and type in some text that you wish to search for. When you see the hit that you would like, press enter and you're taken to the note, and it even flashes yellow briefly to let you know which one it is. Let's just do that again and watch for the yellow flash. I'll click search. I'll type in the text, then press enter on one of those notes. And there, we're taken straight there. So searching for what you need, quick and easy with SideNotes. Let's close off this screencast by looking at the preferences that we have available. So you can get to preferences by pressing Command and Comma, or alternatively, when you're in the folder view, you can click on the cog in the bottom right hand corner. In the menu that appears, select preferences. Now we covered the general tab earlier in the video. So moving across to text, and we've got a few options here. We can increase the size of the text in the notes. So let's open the showcase folder because that's got some text documents at the top. And as I adjust the slider left and right, the text size changes. Moving down, and we can change the default text formatting option from markdown to plain text or to code. And there's also a couple of options for pasting and dropping text. You may wish to remove any indentations from the pasted text or any new lines that would be created. And then finally, at the bottom, you can reduce the size of the file links. So what do we mean by file links? Well, let's go across to the test folder again. And highlighted here on the screen is a file link. If I was to double click on this file link, it will open up the file directly. Now, right now, the link takes up the full width of the note, but if I click the drop down and select compact, we can see that it's reduced. Across to the shortcuts pane now, and there are a lot of keyboard shortcuts available. We have some non-configurable ones at the bottom. However, you can create your own shortcuts for opening and hiding the app window, for pinning it to the desktop, creating a new note, or creating a new note from the pasteboard. And then the final thing that you can do in the preferences is to open up your data folder. So I'll click on open data folder, and a Finder window opens with the SideNotes data contained within. So that's how to use SideNotes. We hope you love it.